Hi students, let's study one more unit from our grammar section for the purpose of our examination and of course for our personal knowledge as well. In the last unit we have studied about direct and indirect speech. Here I go over to another unit, and that is active voice and passive voice. Now it's quite interesting to know about these voices. Though we say active voice and passive voice, well, in simple terms, we call it as using the exact form of verbs. Exact form of verbs which agrees with the subject and number of the verb. Okay, so let us remember this subject. There should be an agreement between the subject and the verb. Okay, so this is what very, very important. Accordingly, the helping verb changes. Helping verb changes. Now, one thing all of us must remember in active and passive voice, or while transforming an active sentence into passive sentence, or sorry, active voice sentence into passive voice, is that unlike indirect speech, here there is no change of tense. I repeat, unlike indirect or reported speech, there is no change of tense. Okay, we maintain the same tense. Then what do we change? As I said, it depends on the subject and the verb agreement. Hence, the number, okay, the past participle form of the verb, that is what we use, and also the helping verb changes depending on the subject. Okay, past participle, everybody writes. Later I will show you the form, but just to remember in mind, okay, first and foremost thing is that tense doesn't change. Tense remains the same. Now, when I give you the introduction or give you the example of active and passive voice, then we come to know. Now, the first of all, the question is this. In active and passive voice, when I give you a sentence, you will understand the meaning doesn't change. For example, Rama killed Ravana. You can write down and find out Rama killed Ravana. This is a sentence which is in active voice. Now, when it is changed into passive voice, you see Ravana was killed by Rama. Ravana was killed by Rama. Rama killed Ravana, or Ravana was killed by Rama, the meaning has not changed. One and the other, the meaning is the same. So why should we make use of active and passive voice at all? Why can't we make use of only active voice? Instead of telling Rama killed Ravana, I say Ravana was killed by Rama. The one who does the action is not changed. The action is the same. Again, the killing is the same. The murder, the killer, okay, one who kills is the same. One who got killed is the same. Then why should we use active and passive voice? Quite interesting, isn't it? Yeah. Remember, it is like this. In active voice, we give importance to the doer of the action. In active voice, we give importance to the doer of the action, one who does the action, the subject. Whereas in the passive voice, the action is given importance. What is done is given importance, and not the doer. Not the doer. So accordingly, we use active voice or passive voice. In case you want to give importance to the doer of the action, to the subject, then we always speak it in active voice. And in case we have to give importance to the action done and the doer is not important for us, it is important whether the action is done or not, then we always use passive voice. Otherwise, there wouldn't have been active and passive voice. So remember, if the doer, subject is important, you need to use always active voice. You cannot use passive voice. And if the action is important and the doer is insignificant, not insignificant in the sense is not important, we are giving importance only for the action that is done, then we need to always use passive voice. Now, let us see the procedure of doing it, and let us take one or two examples, and then we will understand this concept very well and very beautifully as well. Okay, let's take the examples and we will understand. Okay, now, there are some examples. Cheryl sings a song. Cheryl sings a song. Then the next one we have got, Ganesh reads a story. Ganesh reads a story. Okay. Then the third, Thammanna brings down the coconut. Thammanna brings down the coconut. So we have got three sentences here. Okay. Cheryl sings a song, Ganesh reads a story, and Thammanna brings down the tender coconut. Now, these are all called active voice sentences. Okay. You see, what do we do in the active voice? As I told you earlier. Okay. First, the doer of the action is given importance. Who is the doer? See, in the first sentence, for us, it is Cheryl is singing the song. So, Cheryl is the doer of the action. In the second sentence, we have got Ganesh reads a story. So, Ganesh, the doer is Ganesh. Subject of the sentence is Ganesh. So, Ganesh is given importance. And third, Thammanna is the doer of the action. So, he is given importance. Accordingly, you see here, the doer of the action is given importance. Okay, second, the subject is the doer of the action here. So, okay, in this case or here, the subject. Okay, then the verb has an object. What is that? Where the action is done. So, singing is done. Okay, and the object is song here. And reading of the story, and the object is a story. Then, bringing down, what is that? Coconut. You see how these are related here. Okay, how one and the other is related. In other words, the verb has an object. Okay. Active voice has a transitive verb. Okay. It is not intransitive. It is transitive verb. Okay. Now, down below you find here, I have given a formula. What is that? Active voice form. If the subject is the doer of the action, okay, I already told you. If the subject is active, I told you given importance, then the sentence is said to be in active voice. And what is the formula? Or how does it look? First, there is subject. For example, look at here, Cheryl. Okay. Then Ganesh. Okay. Then we have got Thammanna. Okay. The doer. Okay. In other words, the subject or the doer. Second place, there is verb. Which is the verb here? You see, brings down, reads. Okay. And then we have got sings. Then the object is there. What is that? Sing. Okay. Story. Okay, then coconut. See, this form you follow, it becomes an active voice form. Okay, where doer comes first, then the verb, and then the object. Let's go to passive voice and see how it is. Okay, now let us take some example. The song is sung by Cheryl. I have taken the same example. Cheryl sings a song. So, when it's put into passive voice, it becomes, the song is sung by Cheryl. Okay. Ganesh reads a story has become, a story is read by Ganesh. Then, the tender coconut, Thammanna brings down the tender coconut, that has become, the tender coconut is brought down by Thammanna. Okay. Now, when you analyze this sentence, what is here? The action is given importance. Which is the action? Okay, for example, sung. Okay, here, read, and here, brought down or brought. The action is given importance. The past participle form of the verb is used. Look at here. Sing has become sung. Sing, sang, sung. We know present tense, past tense and past participle. Then read, read, read. Okay. So, see the spelling. Okay. Remains the same but pronunciation changes. Then bring, brought, and brought. Okay. So, the past participle form of the verb is used. Okay, so here you see here, passive voice, when the subject is not doing the action. Okay, now here you find in the place of the subject, there is object here. Okay, in the previous sentence we had seen, Cheryl sings a song. Now, song is come to the place of the subject is, subject. When the subject is passive, okay, you find here, Cheryl or Ganesh or Thammanna, they are passive. Then the sentence is said to be in passive voice, you know, passive. Okay, not active, passive. So, what is a form? What is a formula? Okay, how does the sentence say? Subject plus auxiliary verb. What do you mean by auxiliary verb? We call these as auxiliary verb. Okay, here you find is, and here you find is, and here you find is. Okay, they are also called as helping verb. Then, main verb. Which is the main verb here? Sung, read, and brought. okay, main verb, but it is in the past participle form. In the previous sentence, it was in the present tense form. Okay, then plus by, okay, you find by, okay, then the object or the agent. Okay, so you find the song, okay, then the helping verb, auxiliary verb, then the main verb but in past participle form, then the agent, and then the object. Okay, right. Passive form of the verb is used when the subject of the sentence is passive. I told you, in other words, what do you mean by say passive? Where subject is given less importance and the action done is given more importance. Subject is given less importance. Now, you will understand this better. The last sentence that I have written, what is that? The passive is used in science, factual and journalistic writing where the process is or procedure is described. Now, science students would understand this better. For example, when you write a journal, okay, of the experiment that you have done, you write the report. And how do you write? You don't write, I went to the lab and I took a pipette, then I poured a little oxygen, what is that, some kind of, you know, chemical into that. Then I mixed it with another chemical. Then something, I got something and I heated it up. No, we don't do that. How do we say? Okay, the students are taken to the lab. Okay, a pipette is taken. Okay, a chemical is poured. Okay, another chemical is mixed. Okay, the reading is read. Then it is presented. You see, journalistic writing. I'll give you another best example is, suppose I ask you how to prepare coffee, how to prepare tea, and how do you explain to me? You won't say, I go to the kitchen, I take a cup of water, I light the gas or stove, then I keep the vessel, I pour the water. No, 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 no. We know. Okay. Even if you read the newspaper, sometimes they give you the recipe of preparing any of the food items. Okay. Any dishes. And how it is done? The procedural writing. You know how it is? Okay. For example, a glass of water is taken. It is poured into the vessel. The vessel is kept on the stove. The stove is lighted. When the water gets to the boiling point or water is boiled, sugar is added or tea powder is added. When the concoction boils, the gas is put off or the stove is put off. Then the milk is added, then strained, then poured into a cup and served hot. You see, all past participle form of the verb is used and the passive form is used because procedure is always explained in passive format. Why? The doer is not important there. The action is important. What is done is important. That is why they always use the passive form of the sentence. So once again, to bring you back into what you have studied, in active sentence, we give importance to active voice. We give importance to the doer of the action. Whereas in passive sentence, we give importance to the action that is done. Keeping this in mind, let's go further. What are the changes that take place when we change from active to passive voice? Okay, first, active to passive. Okay, change one. What is the change one? The subject of the active sentence becomes the object or the agent of the preposition in the passive sentence. Okay, what do we mean by that? By. Be reminded of that first example. Cheryl sings a song. Cheryl is the subject. Okay, song is the object. Now in the passive voice, the subject of the active sentence becomes the object. I would say the subject takes the place of the object. Okay, it goes to the end of the sentence. So when it is in the passive voice, a song is sung by Cheryl. You see, it goes last, okay, by, and then Cheryl comes, okay, right. Change to, what is the change to? The object of the verb in the active sentence becomes the subject of the passive sentence. Okay, so Cheryl sings a song. When it is in the passive voice, a song or song is sung by Cheryl. Song is sung by Cheryl, object which was at the end of the sentence has come to the place of the subject. Change three. The active form of the verb in active sentence is changed into passive form of the verb in the passive sentence. What do you mean by that? The verb sing we have to write the past participle form. What is that? Sing, sang, sung. Ring, rang, rung. Write, wrote, written. Give, gave, given. Do, did, done. Read, read, read. Write, wrote, written. Okay? Love, loved, loved. Bring, brought, brought. Please remember, nobody can teach this. There is no app to learn. We have to learn it. And this is not the age to learn it. This is not the time. This is expected that you know it. Okay. Change 4. What is that? Form of passive voice verbs. The passive voice requires a double verb. It is sort. What do you mean by double verb? Double verb refers to be form of the verb or helping verb or auxiliary verb. Then the past participle form of the verb. For example, be form. In singular, it is am and is. In the plural, it is are. Okay, are. Then, present tense, it is is and am. Past tense, it becomes was. And are becomes were. Okay, if it is continuous form, being. Okay, or been. The main verb must be in the form of past participle that we already saw. Okay, so please remember this. Okay, please remember this. For which, I would take you to some notes prepared by one of our lecturers from English Forum, Mrs. Rupa Bhatt, and she has got some better and she has explained it well. You can go through the notes and you will find a little better way. Okay, what is that? You see here, let me enlarge. We change sentence from active to passive, we should follow the following points. What is that? Find out the voice. Voice refers to whether it is active voice or passive voice. Good. We understood this point. Then, find out the subject and the object. As I told, who is the subject? The doer of the action. What is the object? What is done or where the action is done upon. If it is singing a song, bringing a thing. Okay. Where the object, where the action is done upon. Find out the tense and use proper helping verb. This is of paramount importance. What do you mean by that? As I told you, in direct indirect language, we change the tense. Whereas in active and passive voice, there is no changing of the tense. Which means you need to find out the tense. Is it present tense? Okay, then it remains present tense. But the helping verb changes according to the subject. There, you must remember, numbered, plural. That also we must remember. I will give you with the example, you will understand. Change the place of the subject and object. This is very well explained. Okay. Subject doesn't become object or object doesn't become subject only. They change the place. Place. Then change the verb in the past participle verb. I told you already. Bring, brought, brought. Then use the preposition by. Agent, it is told already. Don't change the tense. Keep this in mind. Tense doesn't change. Tense remains the same. Tense remains the same. Only the past participle form of the verb comes. Okay. Don't change the meaning. First, I opened this video telling you what is the difference in meaning. Meaning remains the same. Meaning doesn't change. Only the importance given to the doer or to the action changes. Now, the example is given here. Rama killed Ravana. Okay. Now, see the answer. Ravana was killed by Ravana. Now just analyze what are the differences in the active sentence and in the passive sentence. See, Rama killed Ravana. Okay, who is the subject? Rama. Okay, Rama is the subject. Very good. Okay, then who killed is the verb and Ravana is the object. Fine. Now here, Ravana has come to the place of subject. So, Ravana. Now killed is in the past tense. Past tense. So, Ravana is singular. So, which is the helping verb for past tense singular? Was. Was. Okay. Killed. What is the past participle form of killed? Same. Kill, killed, killed. Then the agent by. Then subject comes to the place of object. See? Very well done. Okay. Now, in this example, there are simple given according to the tense. For example, in a simple present, the passive form of the verb is as follows. Okay. To be. Those be forms am, is, or are. Please remember am, is, and are. Now that is in the active voice. In the passive voice, it will be am, is, are, plus past participle form of the verb by, and then the subject. Let's take the example here. We will understand it better. Now, she writes a letter. Now, see here. Subject, she, okay, writes is equal to does plus write a letter. Object, this is an active sentence. Now, see the passive sentence. Subject comes to the place of, object comes to the place of subject, a letter. Okay, now you see a letter, is it singular or plural? A letter is singular. So, which is the helping verb? Singular helping verb. Why is? Because it is in the present tense. So, a letter is. Write, wrote, written. So, the past participle form of write is written. Written. Then the agent, by, and then she, well, changed into her. Okay. So, the object, she, has become there. Okay, we don't say a letter is written by she, but a letter is written by her. Okay, for example, you see there, they answer the questions. Now, subject, they, verb, answer, object, the questions. Now, see how it is done. The questions, now see the questions is plural, which means the helping verb also should be plural. What is that? Instead of is, that is are. The questions are, past participle of the verb, answer is answered, then the agent by, and they has become them. Okay, so the questions are answered by them. Okay, let's go and take the another example. Present continuous form, what happens? This we should know here. For example, example given here is, he is writing a poem. Okay, he is writing a poem. Now here itself, there is a helping verb, and the subject verb is in the continuous form. Now see how it is written. Object comes to the place of subject, a poem. Okay, now a poem is singular, so the helping verb remains same, is. Now you see writing is equal to write. Okay, then there is ing form is added. Okay, so remember, being write, written by him. So, if there is writing in the active voice, when it comes to the passive voice, please remember, we need to introduce being. Okay, the additional being, past participle form of that is used. Being written by him. See here, object, helping verb, being, past participle form of the verb, by, and subject. Can you see here, for example, object, what is that? A poem. Okay, a poem. Then helping verb is, okay, helping verb is, then being, past participle form of the verb, written by, and subject. Okay, take one more example. She is collecting the accounts. Okay, so account comes to the place of subject, hence the accounts. Okay, now see here, she is collecting, whereas the accounts are, why are, accounts is a plural subject, hence the helping verb is also plural. Okay, being has to come here because it is the ing form of the verb being, collected by her. Okay, in the present tense, the passive form of the verb is as follows. What is that? Okay, let's go to the example directly. He has written a poem. We know this is a present perfect tense. Okay. How it is done? A poem has been written by him. He has written a poem, so a poem is the object, it comes to the place of subject. Has remains the same as. Now written, that's when it becomes past perfect, been written. Okay, a poem has been written by him. Please remember, a poem has been written by him. Okay, go another example. She has collected the accounts. So the accounts have, you see here, she has. Why she has? Because she is singular. So the helping verb modal given is has. Whereas here, accounts is a plural. Okay, accounts. So the helping verb is have. Please remember, for singular, it is always, for example, even if it is in the present tense, she has collected the accounts. Whereas they have collected. We have finished our work. Whereas I have finished my work. You have finished your work. And she has or he has finished. Whereas the plural always have. They have, you have, we have. We have. Similarly, here accounts is plural, so the helping verb is also plural. This is what I meant between the subject and verb agreement. Okay, according to the number, singular or plural, the subject should be chosen. Then, since it is present perfect, it becomes been collected by her. Now, see the here object, the accounts have or has, depending on the singular or plural, then been, past participle collected by and her. Okay, let's go and take one more example. In the present perfect continuous tense, passive form is not used because it doesn't come at all. Okay, in the present perfect continuous, what is that? The accounts have been, I have been writing the accounts. She has been writing the accounts. He has been writing the accounts. Already that form is come, so we don't use here. So let's go to run fast over to if it is what about past tense. For example, she wrote a novel. A novel was written by her. Okay, she wrote a novel. Okay, according to the rule, the subject comes to the object comes to the place of subject. A novel. Wrote is in the past tense, so the helping verb is was, and novel is singular, so the helping verb is was. Then the same past participle form by her. They collected the accounts. The accounts were collected by them. Accounts. Okay. Why were? Were because it is the plural subject. Subject is plural, so the helping verb is plural with past tense. Collected by them. In the past continuous passive form of the verb is as follows. We know it very well. How? Okay. She was writing a letter. Now bring the object to the place of subject. A letter was writing, being written by her. Okay. It's very well corresponding past tense. Please remember this. Tense doesn't change, tense remains the same. Okay. They were collecting the accounts. The accounts were being collected by them. Okay. Then in the past perfect, the passive form of the verb is as follows. What is that? He had written a letter. A letter had been written by him. She had collected the accounts. The accounts had been collected by her. Remember now, here, whether it is singular or plural, it remains the same. Helping verb remains the same. Had, it is both the same helping verb for singular or plural. Whereas in present perfect, has, then it is has. Whereas here in the past tense, whether it is singular or plural, it is both, for both it is same. Had. Okay. Whereas in present perfect, if it is singular, it is has. If it is plural, then it is have. In the past perfect continuous tense, form is not used. Same. Future tense. She will write a letter. A letter will be written by her. This is important. A letter will be written by her. Otherwise, the same procedure. They will collect the accounts. The accounts will be collected by them. You see here, there is no additional thing. It's the same. Okay. Then rest you go down. The same procedure is used here. Okay. He will have written a letter. A letter will have been written by her. Okay. We have used the same thing. Okay. Right. He does not write a letter. A novel is not written by him. Even the negative, it's the same that we use not. You understand when we go through the examples. Now let's go back to our other examples and find out how the things are done here. Okay. We finish this. Now the changes is here. Often passive voice sentences will contain a by phrase indicating who or what performed the action or pronouns which changed. For example, I is changed into by me. We changed into by us. You changed into by you. He changed into by him. She by her. It by it. They by them. When the subject of a sentence is singular, the verb must also be singular. When the subject of the sentence is plural, the verb of that sentence must be plural. This is with regard to helping verb. What is that? I am singing. We are singing. I am, because I am singular, so helping verb is am. We, plural, so the helping verb is we are. Okay, you understand this. Okay, now, examples of change of voice according to tense. I told you this just now with the example. So, we will, when we see the sentences, examples, we will understand. Okay, now, this also is not required to us. We have seen. Let's go and see these examples. Okay, one by one. What is that? Juliet. Okay. Now here you will find, let me highlight the color. Okay. Romeo loves Juliet. Okay. Juliet is loved by Romeo. Why? Juliet is helping verb because Juliet is singular. Tamanna is singing a song. A song is being sung by Tamanna. I told you in that rule. Okay. When there is ing form, the being should be used here. Laura occupied a bench in the park. A bench was occupied by Laura in the park. Now, in the park can come in the beginning also. In the park, a bench was occupied by Laura. It can come anywhere, but it should be meaningful. Laura occupied two benches in the park. Two benches were. Now, I want you to see the difference here. A bench was occupied, whereas two benches were occupied. What is this? Just to tell you how the helping verb changes according to the number. That is, a bench singular, if it is plural, were. Okay. God loves the arrow that flies. The arrow that flies is loved by God. Is loved by God. The students write the exam. The exam is written by the students. Now remember, here the subject is plural, but here it is a singular. So remember, not depending on this, but the depending on the passive subject, that is actually the object. Okay. Now let's take the example. In the example, and in the exam for you, we don't ask you to change from active to passive voice, but you are only asked to write the right form of the verb, which means you have to write the passive form of the verb and past participle, okay, helping verb and the past participle. So when you see these examples, you will understand. Now the lesson is already taught to you. A murder was committed in Monaco. The ministers dash summon and it decide to sentence the murderer for life and a guard dash to look after him. Okay. Now how to do the, see, I have done this. This is the answer part of it. A murder was committed in Monaco. The ministers, you see, were summoned. The ministers were. Why ministers were? Ministers is plural. So the helping verb is were. Summon, the past participle is summoned. Okay. Then and it decide. The answer is it was decided. Why it? It is singular. So the helping verb is was. Decide, past participle is decided. To sentence the murderer for life and a guard was placed. Okay. Why was? Because guard is singular and it is past tense. So was placed, past participle, to look after him. One thing you must remember, almost 90% sure that you will be asked the past participle and in this way. It was or were. Okay. So you need not worry, except in 2020 there were some problems that were students faced here, which I will deal at the end of this session. See the second example. The kingdom neither had a guillotine nor an executioner. Therefore a council, see the answer says was called. Okay. So council was called. Then it was decided to write a letter to the French government. The letter was sent. See, all singular. That's why the helping verb is always was, since it is past tense. Okay. If it is present tense, then the council is called. It is decided. The letter is sent. But we are discussing something about the past. So it should be in the past tense. The ministers decided to address an inquiry to the French government to get a guillotine. The letter, okay, see the answer, was sent. Okay, the reply from French was that a machine and an expert could be supplied. Now you may ask me, what is be? I told you be is nothing but the helping verb. We call them as be forms. What is that? Is or am. Past tense is was. Is and am, plural is are. Past tense is were. So they are all called as be forms, different be forms, helping verbs. So could be supplied. Okay, the king thought it over that the people wouldn't stand it. Again, a council was called. Okay, council singular, past tense, was called, past participle, called. In the toy kingdom, a council dash, again, was called. Okay, council was called to consider what could be done. I told you there are, see, could remains because already past participle of could is could. Do, past participle is done. Okay. And it was decided to send the letter to the king of Italy. The prince agreed to show mercy, and so the matter was arranged. Matter singular, helping verb is was, past participle arranged. The only problem was that there was no suitable prison for a person who was sentenced for life. However, there was a small lockup where people were kept. Why were? Because people is plural, so the helping verb is were. Keep, kept, kept. The king of Monaco was looking over the accounts. A new item of expenditure. Okay, what is the answer? Was noticed. Expenditure, singular, was noticed by him. In order to reduce this expenditure, the guard was dismissed. Was dismissed. And the criminal was asked to run away. You see, all singular. That's why was. If there was plural, it would have been were. It would have been were. Okay. Tammanna had 1,000 acres where Basavayya owned only 800. A word was sent. Once again, why was sent? Because a word, singular, past tense, was, past participle, sent. Okay. When Tammanna did not agree, his 200 acres of land was acquired. Now you may tell me, Father, 200 is here. But we are not discussing about 200 plural. We are discussing about land. Okay. 200 of acres of land was acquired. Land, one concept. You know, like one group. One group is, it contains plural, but group is one. Similarly, 200 acres of land is considered as one unit. One unit. So it was not that 200 acres of land were acquired. Please remember, 200 acres of land was acquired. For example, I have got a bunch of keys. Now, bunch of keys is, or bunch of keys are. Bunch of keys is, because how many bunches? Only one bunch. There are many keys in that. Okay. Classroom has got many students. Okay. A group of students came to meet me. A group of students, not a group, groups of students. Though there are students in the group is only one unit. Similarly here, though there are 200 acres, it is not plural. We are considering that land as one unit. That's why was acquired by Basavayya. A fence was built. A fence was built. Okay, remember, singular was built. Roof, okay, dash to everyone in Umofia. Okay, see, roof knew everyone in Umofia. When it is past passive voice, roof was known to everyone. Was known, known. The campaigner of POP party met him. No words. See here, were wasted. Why were? Words is plural. Okay, and the helping, it is in the past tense. So are, past tense is were. Were wasted between them. Roof, again singular, so was given. Okay. Roof was given £5 to cast his vote for Madhuka. Roof was given. Then one more example. Cycles became the most popular means of transport in Pudukottai. Women, now you see here, were seen. Why were? Because woman singular, here it is women. It is plural. So plural, helping verb also plural. Since it is past tense, are becomes were. So women were seen cycling to their workplaces. Their dependence on men was reduced. Men, dependence on men, men is plural. Then why was? We are not speaking about men. We are speaking about their dependence, which is singular. Okay. Their dependence, which is singular. The dependence on men was reduced. An all women cycling rally was organized. You see, women plural, but we are speaking about cycling rally. Cycling rally singular. So was organized. Take this example. I think this will make things very clear to us, and there are many other examples also. Which are those? For example, Marcus Ibe had built a mansion in his village and had christened it Umofia Mansions in honor of his village. His house was installed. The answer is his house was installed. Why was installed? House is singular. So was. Okay. Past participle of install is installed. With a private plan to supply electricity. People of the village were invited. Now why were invited? People of the village. People refers to plural. So helping verb also is a plural. Were, past participle, invited. Countless goats were slaughtered. Goats, plural, so were, slaughter, past participle, slaughtered. Now I have given one example here. Okay, and see the answers below. Little different. What is that? When a patient dash detect with COVID-19, he dash to a COVID hospital and dash by many doctors. The doctors and the nurses dash as real angels. COVID dash not spread by the air but only by physical contact. Now this paragraph is very very related to the present context. Okay, it is not something of the past. This is something of the present. So things are to be in the present tense, not past tense, unlike all the examples from the textbook that we saw. So how it is now? See here, when the patient is detected. Why is detected? As I said, okay, now the things are happening presently. So it is in the present tense. That's why helping verb is. Whereas past participle form, that we can't help it. It has to be past participle. But the helping verb is not when the patient was detected. Why? This is a present scenario. Present scenario. Please remember this. Okay. With COVID-19, he is taken. See, I have explained the procedure when a patient is infected, what to do, what is done usually. I have explained the procedure. And usually a procedure is in the passive voice and it is always in present tense. Present tense. Okay. Then, COVID hospital and is treated by many doctors. Is treated by many doctors. The doctors and the nurses are considered, please remember here, are considered, doctors and nurses plural, are considered as real angels. COVID does not spread by the air. Now here we don't have a past participle form of the verb. Okay, only be is given, helping verb. Okay, COVID is not spread by the air. So COVID does not spread by the air but by physical contact. Okay, maybe some of you can argue, can I write here COVID is? Okay, COVID is not spread by the air but by physical contact, because here we don't require the passive form at all. This is what happened in 2020 March or April exam, or rather which was conducted in the month of June. Okay, the students got confused. Students got confused. It was a mixture of present tense and past tense. But please remember, usually it is not a mixture of present tense, past tense. Usually it is completely past tense, which means it could be was and were that way. But sometimes it can be a mixture of present tense and past tense. Hence you have to be little bit careful, little bit careful. Okay, if there is an example of the 2020 exam, I can tell you, which is like this. Okay. The question read, Tapovan dash by Rabindranath Tagore. In the bracket it is given right. So Tapovan was written by Rabindranath Tagore, a national poet. According to him, the culture of the forest dash by the diverse processes of renewal of life. In the bracket influence. So according to him, the culture of the forest is influenced. Because it is not only in the past, always. The culture of the forest is always, it is a universal truth. So, the culture of the forest is, it is relevant even today, it is present tense, is influenced by the diverse process of the renewal of life. The forest dash the universe, in the bracket symbolize, the forest symbolizes the universe. The forest symbolizes the universe. You see, there is a mixture of past tense and present tense. So, students got confused. Students got confused. That's why it's very, very important that we read many things. And when we read today, what we have to see is, what is the voice? Is it active or passive? And how it is written? Remember, English we don't study to understand the story or other things. English we study to improve our language skill. So when you read any text or even newspaper or when you listen, you have to always pay your attention to all these things. How the sentence is made, how the voice is made use of, which tense, okay, which voice, reported or indirect or direct. All these things should be paid attention. And even when we correct, this is what we look into. So please remember, you pay attention and all the things will be sorted out. So I request you once again to go through all the examples again and again, and things will be very clear to you. Other things we can sort out in the classroom. Thank you very much.